Tom, come on up. What's one of the biggest mistakes that small business owners make when trying to market their small business?
Oh, that's a great question. Probably one of the most common mistakes is not coming up with a marketing plan and, importantly, a budget. So people just try stuff. You know, Yelp gives them a call, okay, I'll try it. I don't know if it worked, maybe it did, maybe it didn't. I'll try something else. And they're not thinking about what are the metrics that you need to measure against.
That's a good answer. And whenever any one of us as a small business owner gets a call for anyone saying that they can get us on the front page of Google, what do you say to that?
Well, anyone can get on the front page of Google by just bidding for an AdWord for a keyword phrase that nobody cares about, because they're very cheap and you can guarantee it. So if anyone's guaranteed you a good response on Google, think twice, and I'd be happy to walk you through that.
Good. Excited to hear what you have to say.
All right. Woo-hoo. Well, I'm excited to talk about this because this is a very, very interesting topic. I just have to remember to press, what was it? Input?
AV mute.
Oh, mute. There we go. All right. But before I jump into this, I wondered, could I possibly have a volunteer? Is there anyone who has their cell phone, who has their smartphone on them, who uses Facebook on it? Okay.
Religious
service in here. Okay, well, good. Well, come on up. Because you said religiously.
Hallelujah.
Right. Can you, I'd like you to go to a Facebook site right now on your phone. It's called Smartway America. Now, if you really wanted to buy or sell a house, you'd go to Daryl Wass, and he would take care of you. But in East Stroudsburg, Pennsylvania, there's a realtor out there by the name of Smartway America. Smartway America, yeah.
That's Realty.
Yep. Okay, go to that one. Go ahead and click on that. And then go ahead and send them a message. Okay.
Tell them you got good oatmeal.
Yeah, you can go ahead and type that. Actually, okay, so there it is. So go ahead and read what you're seeing there, because I think, and I wanted to show this to you on the screen, but unfortunately that Apple's browser is not updated properly, so we can't do it. But what does
it
say?
So it says, typically replies instantly, tap get started below. Barb Bot would love to help you with all your real estate needs, buying, selling mortgages. Get started below.
All right, so hit the get started. And there you go. So what does it say now?
Hello, Liz. I'd like to introduce Don Jordan, broker, Smartway America Realty. Wow, we just keep going.
Right, so she's got a picture of this realtor.
Sure, and it just tons of messages.
Okay, and then what is it? What are the options that you have there at the bottom?
Buying, selling, pre-qualification, message, Don.
Okay, why don't you pick, I don't know, buying.
Dan, you're drinking.
Dan, guess what? Open up the wall, man.
Guess what I'm buying.
So it says, looks like you want to buy a new home, and what areas are you interested in buying in? First tell me, you want to search by town or school district?
All right, we'll do one more. So go ahead and pick town.
Which town?
Okay, good. Pick East Stroudsburg.
Bushkill.
Okay, whichever.
That just sounds interesting.
I would enjoy your new home. Okay, so is the style of home important? So it's basically, it's walking her through a little questionnaire online. It'll show her pictures of different houses. Now, who is this person on the other end of Facebook? You can, thank you. Yes, no, I really appreciate that. But that is a bot. That is not an actual person on the other end that Liz has just friended. So what's a bot? Well, we're going to be talking about this because this is one of the most exciting developments on the internet that we've had since mobile devices and since social media and since search marketing. So first of all, let's talk about a platform. What's a platform? A platform is a computer technology that provides access to software. So, for example, going all the way back to the 1990s, when you had those, you know, your personal computer, your PC, and you would be using it, I don't know who remembers that, but okay, well, I remember it. It was before the internet, or the internet was so new it wasn't really significant. Well, that was your platform. It was just your computer. And we all used to talk about, someday computers are going to talk to each other. And we imagined it was like mainframes connected and the Whopper computer from War Games and all that stuff. And it turned out to just be a little bit simpler than that. It was the internet. And over time, in the 90s, the browser started to become your platform over the computer. In other words, today, when you go on your browser, you're going to websites, and those are giving you the software that you want to use. We use time tracking software, we use QuickBooks, all of that is coming, a lot of it is coming online. I don't actually download it onto my computer. Well, so the platform is now moving from the browser to an app, a certain type of app called a messaging app. And so when Liz was just on Messenger, that's an app that provides a platform for what we call chatbots, or bots for short. Now, chatbots aren't the only kind of bot. If Liz had gone, I don't know, is it an iPhone?
No, just Android.
Okay, so it's Android. So you had, Google Assistant on there. Okay, so that's a bot. So asking Google Assistant, can you look up something, or tell me what a cow sounds like, or things like that. That my son loves that. That's why I said that. But anyway, so those are bots, and what they are they're automated tasks performed by software in a human-like way. They're generally repetitive tasks, and the point of them is that they save a lot of time. So let's say Liz did want to buy a house through this guy in East Stroudsburg. Well, now this person already knows what kind of house she wants to buy. He has her information. She's answered a lot of questions. Or let's say Liz didn't actually want to talk to a person to do it. Maybe she wanted to make a contribution, say, to a charity, but she wasn't sure if that charity was really responsible with their money. Instead of having to go to their website or GuideStar or any of a number of other resources and do lots of searches, she could ask a bot to do those searches for her and find out what their overhead is and how much they spend on administrative costs. So bots are going to be changing how not just big business works, but small business too. So the common examples of bots are like CNN, Nordstrom's, they all have bots now, but small businesses are getting them as well. So anyway, we covered some of this. I'm trying to go through it quickly because I wanted to tell you about the Marketing GPS workshop. Elijah, could you pass out those?
Yes.
Oh, they're already there. Okay, so you guys have this. We're gonna go into a lot more detail on June 21st about this. But this is a good illustration of how messaging is the new platform and how bots are replacing apps. Because apps have fallen off. It used to be if you wanted to start a hot new business in like 2013, you'd start an app company and you'd create apps. But now we all have like dozens of apps on our phones, and we don't always think about updating them. Many of them will just visit one time and will never go again. The exception to that are messaging apps. When people talk about teenagers spending all day on their phones, they're not making phone calls. They're on messaging apps. And many of them are starting to use these bots. They're also talking to their friends and so forth. But we're getting natural language sequencing and artificial intelligence to the point where the computer can start to talk to you like a human and help answer questions and so forth. So messaging is the new platform, and bots ride on top of that. And here's the whole history of it. I'd love to talk about this, but we don't have time. It started with the Turing test, so Alan Turing, if you know about the Enigma and so forth. But anyway, so chatbots have been around for a long time, but there are this incredible rise. This is 10 million users now on WhatsApp. I mean, that's, I'm sorry, not 10 million, 1 billion users on WhatsApp. And that's just one of them. There's also Kik, there's Messenger, there are quite a few others. And so now bots could replace apps because they're kind of cross-platform. They allow you that you can ask questions, get answers, and they're easier to build than apps are, because with an app, you gotta figure out, okay, what's my color palette? What happens when I change the phone's orientation? Lots of different factors go into that, but with a bot, the interface has already been set up by whatever messaging platform you're writing on. So if it's Facebook, well, you know what that's gonna look like. You don't have to decide a color. You can just figure out what the dialogue is. And so think of thousands and thousands of people in jobs that are that you rely on scripts. These people need to really be starting to look for new jobs. But they can now use that knowledge to create the content for all of this. So I'm gonna just, I'll go through all of this some other time, but I wanted to tell you guys, oh, what's the other time? The Marketing GPS Workshop. So we're gonna talk about this in detail, how you can use it to generate leads, how you can work with landing pages. It's our 8th annual one, and it's coming up on Wednesday, June 21st. It's a webinar, so you can do it from your desk. It's a fundraiser to support the Ronald McDonald House. It's part of our Marketing GPS offering of very low-cost services that help raise awareness. And you get a B&I and an early bird discount. I think that's all the time I have. Thank you very much.